وما أرسلنا من قبلك إلا رجالا نوحي إليهم فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وخيرته من خلقه وأمينه على وحيه، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، أما بعد. Inshallah, today, which is the second part for the series in which we started, how does a student of knowledge build his library? Inshallah, today we're going to speak about the shuruh of kutubu as-sitta. Ama shuruh kutubu as-sunnah as-sitta. And we'll also speak about the kutubu as-sitta in general. And then after that we will head to speak about, or we will speak about after that, the kutubu as-sitta and their shuruh. But as a muqaddimah, as an introduction, I wanted to point out that the masadir al-sharia, and the masadir al-asliya in our religion, after the kitab of Allah Azza wa Jal, the ulama, they divide into two. They divide the masadir al-asliya ila qismain, to two. Those masadir which are the sources that are, the original sources that are kutub al-hadithiyya, the books of hadith, that the author of that book will narrate the hadith and the speeches of the scholars, meaning the sahaba and the atba' al-tabi'in, the athar, bi asanidihim, with his chain of narration. So he will narrate the narration from him to the messenger, if it's a hadith. And if it's an athar, a narration from a sahaba or the tabi'in or the atba' al-tabi'in, he will also narrate it with his chain of narration. عن طريق التلقي عن شيوخهم, the way he took it from his sheikh, and where his sheikh took from, and where his sheikh took from, until to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is called al-kutub al-hadithi, masadir al-asliyyah lil-kutub al-hadithiyya. From them are the Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, and Abu Dawood, and Jami' al-Tirmidhi, and Sunan al-Nisa'i, and Sunan ibn Majah, and Musnad Imam Ahmad, and Muwatta Imam Malik, and other than that. And this is the first one that we're, this is the point that we shall be speaking about, inshallah, in this part, inshallah, which is the second part. We will be speaking about the first type of the masadir al-asliya. The second type of masadir al-asliya are the other subjects in the religion, kalfunun al-ukhra, which are not the science that are not hadith, such as seven that I'm going to mention. The first one is the books of tafsir. The books of tafsir, they are also considered masadir al-asliya when there is a chain of narration from this mufassir, the one that's commenting on the Quran, from him to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every time he quotes an explanation of an ayah. And from those are the likes of عبد الرزاق بن همام الصنعاني ابن جرير الطبري ابن أبي حاتم. You will find in their books that all of them, they narrate any quotes they bring in their books from themselves to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or from themselves to the Sahabas, or from themselves to the Atba' al-Tabi'in. But if you try to come to some of the books of tafsir like Zad al-Masir, Ibn al-Jawzi, مثلاً, or if you come to tafsir al-Imam al-Qurtubi, or the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, they are not considered masadir al-asliya. لا تعتبر masadir al-asliya. Why? لأن صاحبها لا يروون الأحاديث والآثار فيها بسندهم. Because they don't bring the, Ibn Kathir, for instance, does not bring the chain of narration from himself to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly. He doesn't. So because of that, his book is not considered as a masdar al-asliya. The second one is the books of fiqh. The books of fiqh are also considered masadir al-asliya with a condition that the chain of the author of the book to him and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is connected, such as الإمام الشافعي من كتاب الأم يعتبر مصدرا أصليا. Why? Because إمام الشافعي إذا روى فيه حديثا أو أثرا رواه بسنده. Because الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله when he narrates a quote or a hadith, he narrates it from himself to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم directly. Also الإمام ابن حزم من كتاب المحلى يعتبر مصدرا أصليا. It's considered as a مصدر أصلي. The reason is because Ibn Hazm also does that. When he narrates a quote from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he brings his chain of narration. So this book, the second book in Fiqh, which is the book of Ibn Hazm, is also considered. Whereas if you go to the Kitab al-Mughni مثلا by Ibn Qudam al-Maqdisi, or you go to al-Majmu' by Imam al-Nawawi, and other than those books, these are not considered masadir al-asliya. Why? Because al-Imam al-Nawawi al-Majmu' when he brings a hadith, he doesn't ascribe it from himself to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So because of that, it's not considered masdar al-asliya. The third one of the second part is usul al-fiqh. The majority of the books of usul al-fiqh لا تعتبر مصادر أصلية. They're not considered as an original source. Except the kitab written by Imam al-Shafi'i al-Risala. يعتبر مصدر أصليا. Why? لأن because إن الشافعي إذا روى فيه شيئا من الأحاديث والآثار رواه بسنده. He brings it with his chain of narration. The same is the books of language. كتب اللغة. If you go to, for example, تهذيب اللغة للأزهري, الإمام الأزهري, everything he mentions from the أحاديث and the آثار, he brings سند for it. So because of that, his book has become what? مصدر أصلية. The fifth one is books. books that are tarikh, history. كالبداية والنهاية مثلا. نعم كتب التاريخ that are considered مصادر أصلية is the likes of تاريخ الأمم والملوك لابن جرير الطبري. نعتبره مصدرا أصليا لأن ابن جرير الطبري إذا روى فيه شيء رواه بالسند. So this is considered. Whereas بداية والنهاية لا يعتبر. لا نعتبره مصدرا أصليا. البداية والنهاية we don't consider it. Why? Because the Imam Ibn Kathir does not narrate it from himself to the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم the narrations. The same applies with books of manners and adab and literature. كالأخبار الموفقيات لزبير ابن بكار. This book is a book of literature, adab, which is considered a مصدر أصليا. Why? Because زبير بن بكار يروي الأحاديث والآثار فيه بسنده. He can, if he narrates a hadith or he narrates a speech of the Sahabas, it's considered what? نعم. Also, the books of سير. The books of سير, biographies. And the likes of those is the book written by Imam al-Bukhari, Tariq al-Kabir. أو طبقات الكبرى لابن سعد. These are considered to be مصادر الأصلية في كتب علم الرجال when it comes to the books of science of men. Why? Because Bukhari in his book تاريخ الكبير and Imam ibn Sa'd in his طبقات الكبرى when they narrate a quote or a speech or anything they have chains of narrations in it. Also المغازي by ابن إسحاق is مصدر أصلي وهلم جرة and other than that. So we said the original sources that we take from after the Kitab of Allah is divided into two. الكتب الحديثية التي ذكر فيها مؤلفوها الحديث والآثار بأسانيدهم. The second part is كتب الفنون الأخرى أي غير الحديثية التي يروي فيه مؤلفوها الحديث والآثار والحكايات بأسانيدهم أيضا عن طريق التلقي عن شيوخهم. That's a مقدمة in the topic that we're going to speak about today. So if we look at the two that we mentioned now, which one will the Kutubu A'imma to Sita fall into? It falls into the type of the first type of the books of hadith that we mentioned. And inshallah, we're going to start with Al-Imam Al-Bukhari Rahimahullah, his kitab. The reason why we start with Imam Al-Bukhari's kitab, لأنه أصح كتاب بعد كتاب الله. Bukhari's book is the most authentic book after the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. is the first, is the most authentic book after the Kitab of Allah Azza wa Jal. ولذلك الإمام العراقي says وأول من صنف في الصحيح محمد وخص بالترجيح ومسلم بعد وبعض الغرب مع أبي علي فضل ذا لو نفع. The first person who wrote an authentic book in which he conditioned authenticity in his book is Imam al-Bukhari. And his book became the most authentic book after the Kitab of Allah Azza wa Jal. Abu al-Hajjaj, al-Hafidh al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi rahimahullah, in his book Tahdhib al-Kamal, in which we're inshallah going to speak about the manhaj of Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, and which book did he do a tahdhib from, inshallah, when we come to it, bi-idhnillah. He mentions in the first volume in his kitab, page 147. He says, وَأَمَّا السُّنَّةِ, as in regards to the sunnah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ وَفَّقَ لَهَا حُفَّاظًا. Allah has placed for the sunnah people who are going to protect the sunnah. عَارِفِينَ, who are aware of this field. They know hadith very well. وَجَهَابِذَةٌ عَالِمِينَ, and scholars who defend and stand up for the hadith and the sunnah with knowledge and understanding and preciseness in its defects that may occur from others. وَسِيَارِفِهِ النَّاقِدِينَ, and those who divert any things that may be brought to it, they have the ability and the strength in order to defect it. ينفون عنه تحريف الغالين وانتحار المبطلين وتأويل الجاهلين. They negate from it the alternation that comes from the one that's going extreme in it. And the misguided one who brings false accusation against it, they're also there to defect it from it. And the interpretation of the ignorant, they're also able to defect it from it. فتنوعوا في تصانيفها. And because of that, their authoring in books of hadith have become different. وَتَفَنَّنُوا فِي تَدْوِينِهَا, and in publishing it, it became different. عَلَىٰ أَنْحَاءٍ كَثِيرَةٍ وَضُرُوبٍ عَدِيدَةٍ, in different ways and different forms. حِرْسًا عَلَىٰ حِفْظِهَا, and the whole intent behind it for each and every one of them, even though the intention from each book, because you're going to see it inshallah, that the books are different. Some are jami', some are sunan, some are masanid, some are musannafat, some are muwatta'at. We spoke about that in our first part. But the intent for all of them was what? حِرْسًا عَلَىٰ حِفْظِهَا, to protect the sunnah from any of those and claims that come from the ignorant ones and the alternation that the ignorant ones try to put on this religion. نعم. وَخَوْفًا مِنْ إِضَاعَتِهَا, and also fear that it may become forsaken. نعم. وَكَانَ مِنْ أَحْسَنِهَا تَصْنِيفًا, and the best books that were written in this, وَأَجْوَدِهَا تَأْلِيفًا, and the best of those that authored, وَأَكْثَرِهَا صَوَابًا, and the one that's closest to the correctness is, وَأَقَلُّهَا خَطَأً, and the one that has the littlest of mistakes, وَأَعَمِّهَا نَفْعًا, and the one that encompasses the most benefits, وَأَعْظَمِهَا بَرَكَةً وَأَيْسَرُهَا مَؤُونَةً وَأَحْسَنُهَا قَبُولًا عِنْدَ الْمُوَافِقِ وَالْمُخَالِفِ. It has the virtuous and the most greatest and the fullest of barakah, and the most best in terms of acceptance according to the one that agrees and the one that disagrees. وَأَجَلِّهَا مَوْضِعًا عِنْدَ الْخَاسَةِ وَالْعَامَةِ, is what? صحيح أبي عبد الله محمد بن إسماعيل البخاري, most authentic. ثم صحيح أبي الحسين مسلم بن حجاج النيسابوري, ثم بعدهما, after these two, كتاب السنن لأبي داود سليمان بن الأشعث السجستاني, after that سليمان أبي داود سليمان بن الأشعث السجستاني, إمام أبو داود comes third after that, ثم كتاب الجامع, and after that the كتاب الجامع by who, لأبي عيسى محمد بن عيسى الترمذي, ثم كتاب السنن لأبي عبد الرحمن أحمد بن الشعيب النسائي, ثم كتاب السنن لأبي عبد الله محمد بن يزيد المعروف بابن ماجة القزويني وإن لم يبلغ درجتهم. Then he says, ولكل واحد من هذه الكتب الستة, for each and every one of these six books, ميزة يعرفها أهل هذا الشأن, it has something which is unique in, that the people of this field are able to know. this book is better, is good in this one, and this is good in this, and this is good in this. Each one has a miza, meaning something that it's good in, and it has precedency over the other one on. فاشتهرت هذه الكتب بين الأنام. So these books spread amongst the ummah. وانتشر في بلاد الإسلام, and it spread in the lands of the believers, in the Muslims. وعظم الانتفاع بها. And the benefit of it, it encompassed everybody. You see, وحرس طلاب العلم على تحصيلها. And the students of knowledge strived as much as they could to gain these books and get it. وصنفت فيه تصانيف. And books have been written on it. وعلقت عليها تعاليق. And people came and they put their pen on it, meaning شروح and explanations on it. So this is the call of Imam Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi. So he put Bukhari first. After that, Muslim, and after that, Abu Dawud, and after that, Tirmidhi, and after that, An-Nasa'i. And finally, last but not least, he put Sunani Ibn Majah. So these are the six books of Mahatul Sittah. Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, and Tirmidhi, and Nasa'i, there's an ijma' that they are the five that are chosen. Meaning these five, there's an ijma' on it. These five, there's an ijma' on these five. There's a khilaf that occurred from the ulama on the sixth one. والخلاف في السادس معروف. It's known. فمنهم من جعل السادس. From some scholars, they made the sixth one موطا إمام مالك. Like who? Ibn Athir in his kitab جامع الأصول. رزين العبدري in تجريد الأصول. In تجريد الأصول, he made the موطا إمام مالك, the sixth one. Some made سنن الدارمي, and some made سنن ابن ماجه. And the first person who made سنن ابن ماجه, Sunan ibn Majah, the sixth one, the first one who made it, was none other than Abu al-Fadl ibn Tahir al-Silafi. In his kitab, in his Atraf, and he has a book called Shurut A'immatu Sitta. He has a book called Shurut A'immatu Sitta. He made the sixth one, Sunan ibn Majah. ثم تبعه على ذلك من كتب في الشروط وفي الأطراف وفي رجال الكتب. And after him followed this in his view, in his book of conditioning, and in his Atraf, who? عبد الغني عبد الواحد المقدسي. عبد الغني عبد الواحد المقدسي, the author of the kitab عمدة الأحكام. He has a book and called أطراف, and he has also a book called الكامل في معرفة الرجال, and that's the book that Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, he done the tahdhib of, which he called, Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid is called his one, Al-Kamal fi Ma'rifat al-Rijal. Abdul Hajjaj came, he done a tahdhib of it. Inshallah that will come to us when we come to the Kutub of Takhrij. So the first person who said that the sixth one is Sunan ibn Majah, is first was Abu al-Fadl ibn Tahir al-Silafi. He wrote in his Atraf and his Shurut, Shurut Aymat Sitta. After him came Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi, he followed him in that. After him came who? Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, as we just quoted from him in his Tahdhib al-Kamal. He also followed him in that. After him came who? Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, who done the Tahdhib of the Kamal. After him came Ibn Hajar, who followed him in his view. And then after that, it became famous that the sixth one was Ibn Majah. And because of that, in our series, inshallah, of this chapter, inshallah, we're going to speak about, بإذن الله الكريم, the sixth book, six books, meaning Sahih al-Bukhari, and Sahih al-Muslim, and Sunan Abi Dawood, and Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Sunan al-Nisa'i, and Sunan ibn Majah. And because there's a khilaf whether Muwatta Malik is in it or not, we will also speak about the Muwatta of Imam Malik of it as well. Now there's a nuqta, a point in which I want to stand on, which is, some people do itlaqu الصحيح على ما عدا الصحيحين. Some people they consider صحيح other than the two books صحيحين, Bukhari and Muslim. And this is a تساهل. This is تساهل, meaning this is too much lenience to consider a book to be صحيح in general and just say authentic book like that other than صحيح البخاري is a lenience in, from that person. It's تساهل because Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim are the only two books that we know to be Sahih. The other books, inshallah, when we see, they have in them Sahih and Hasan and Daif. And rather Ibn Majah has mawdu', a fabricated hadith, as some of the ulama said. So for you to say that this is sahih like that is wrong. And one of the scholars that said that is Al-Hafidh al-Silafi, Ibn Tahir al-Silafi. He said, أَنَّ الْأُمَّةَ تَلَقَتْهُمَا بِالْقَبُولِ وَاتَّفَقُوا عَلَى صِحَّةِ أُصُولِهَا. Abu Tahir al-Silafi said that the Ummah have accepted it and taken it with acceptance. And they agreed upon its authenticity in its usul. In accordance to, so he's talking about all the six books. We will say, أما بالنسبة للصحيحين فلا خلاف في صحة ما جاء فيهما. As for Bukhari and Muslim, everything that's in it is sahih, we agree with you on that. The Ummah have agreed upon that. وما عداهما أذن صحيح البخاري and Muslim, إطلاق الصحة عليه فيه نظر. There's a look into that. And the speech that Abu Tahir al-Silafi, which we quoted anifan, he says that it is. Some scholars have also considered Sunan al-Nisa'i to just be sahih. So they say sahih Sunan al-Nisa'i. Some say Abu Dawood is sahih. So they say sahih Sunan Abi Dawood bimufradihi. Some even said that Tirmidhi rahimahullah is sahih. His book is called Jami'u al-Sahih. وَعَلَى كُلِّ حَالٍ فَهَذَا تَسَاهُلٌ مِمَّنْ أَطْلَقَهُ. على كل حال, this is all تساهل. ولذلك عراقي الألفية, he says, ومن عليها أطلق الصحيحة فقد أتى تساهلا صريحا. Anyone who says that something is authentic after صحيحين, other than صحيحين, فقد أتى تساهلا صريحا. That person has come with a تساهل which is clear. لا شك أن إطلاق الصحيح على ما عدا الصحيح فيه تساهل. There's no doubt about that. Because they have what other than that. Also, there's another point which is Imam al-Baghawi rahimahullah in his kitab Masabih al-Sunnah. His istilah, he done a terminology when he was talking about the books, the Kutub al-Sunan. He said that the Kutub al-Sunan, the hadith that are in it are either Sihah or Hisan. His kitab Masabih al-Sunnah, he qasam al-kitab ila al-qismain, he divided to two. Sihah wal Hisan. He says that everything that's in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim are Sahih. And anything that's in the A'immat al-Sunan, like the four A'immat al-Sunan, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Nasa'i, those four, he says that all of that that's in it is Sahih, is Hasan. And anything that's in Bukhari and Muslim is Sahih. This is whose terminology? Baghawi. وهذا الكلام لا شك أنه مردود. That kalam, no doubt, is rejected. Because, as we said before, in the Aimat al-Sunan, the four, we find in their books, Hassan. We find in their books, Sahih. We find in their books, Daif. And that's why Iraqi al-Alfi also says, وَالْبَغَوِيُّ إِذْ قَسَّمَ الْمَصَابِحَ إِلَى الصِّحَاحِ وَالْحِسَانِ جَانِحَ أَنَّ الْحِسَانَ مَا رَوَوهُ فِي السُّنَنِ رُدَّ عَلَيْهِ إِذْ بِهَا غَيْرُ الْحَسَنِ. والبغوي إذ قسم المصابيح بمعنى مصابيح السنة his كتاب, he divided into what, إلى الصحاح والحسان جانحة. Those two, صحاح حسن and what, صحيح. This is what he did. So he said everything that's in Bukhari is صحيح and everything that's in the أئمة السنن الأربعة is what, حسن. You see, أن الحسان ما رووه في السنن, everything that's narrated in the كتب أئمة the four سنن is صحيح, is حسن. Iraqi says, "Rudda alayhi idh biha ghayrun hasan." Rudda is rejected from him. Is rejected from him, and that which he said, which is wrong. Now, that's one nuqta I wanted to alert on before we start and go into Bukhari. Also, another point which is important is why is it? لماذا لم يجعل الأئمة مسند إمام أحمد بن محمد رحمه الله في الكتب الستة? Why is it that the scholars have not made Bukhari Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal's musnad from the Kutub al-Sunnah Sita? Why? لماذا لم يجعل أئمة مسند إمام أحمد رحمه الله في كتب الستة؟ لا سيما not to mention أن شروط الإمام أحمد في مسنده قوي جدا ولا يقل عن شرط أبي داود. Rather, it's known that إمام أحمد بن حنبل's conditions is more stronger than the conditions of أبو داود. It's more stronger. إن لم يكن أعلى منه. Rather, it can even be even higher than him. As إمام شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله mentioned. And anyone who's done mutala'ah and read the book of Sunan Musnad Imam Ahmad will find that Imam Ahmad's Musnad has a stronger shart condition than Ibn Sunan Abi Dawud. Rather.